election day. Uh-oh. Come on now. Gotta wake up. Gotta go vote. 19 minutes after 7 o'clock, it is Tuesday, November 8th, 2016. It is election day.
Yeah, thank God. It will be over.
And you are listening to your radio. I mean, you might be curious how I know that, but I just know it.
How's that they're listening? Yeah, I know. You're magic. You're so good.
I'm absolutely confident that they're listening to their radio. I'm absolutely confident. It's 59 degrees here at the Echoey studio here.
Mm-hmm.
Try to fix that. There it goes. I'll never figure out does that in the beginning. All right, 59 degrees right now. The forecast is calling for mostly cloudy skies, only a 20% chance of rain. No reason to stay away from the voting polls, the voting precincts, whatever you want to call them. And high temperatures today around 80 degrees. The rest of the week looks pretty good. 80 degrees or less all week long. And overcast and clear is all it says, and very little mention of rain. Lows at night around 50, 53. So there you go. I don't have any fan on anymore at night. It feels good. Open the window and listen to the birds, and if you go to bed early enough, which I do, you hear children out there still playing. So
that's nice.
Today's election day, 7:35 till 8 o'clock this morning. We will talk about the news. If you want to talk about the elections, you are invited to do that. We kind of did that yesterday, but I have so much other news that it's not necessary. I'm sure most of you have already made up your mind who you're voting for, not just in the presidential race, but also in the other races as well. May the best person win in all of those races.
Yep, the best candidate for the particular position they're running for.
8:35 is News Bites. That's where we read the news and do not offer commentary. It's simple as that. 9:05, one of my favorite segments of the week, is when Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin comes in and does her show called In the Garden with Carol Ann, and she'll be answering your questions about your lawns and your gardens and telling you how you can use manure and fix those gardens. Well, I just thought on election day it would be good to mention the word manure just one time.
I think that's a good idea.
Matt Gibbs is going to vote on which car he thinks is the best. I know which one he does. Oh, and I'm not going to say what he doesn't like. But there's a few cars he just doesn't like.
Yeah.
There's a few brand names he just doesn't like. He's not a big fan of the Volkswagen, I can tell you that.
No.
Anyway, he does his show at 10:05, and he'll answer questions about cars. Chris Bird at 10:35. Chris is a former British Army officer. He served in the Royal Military Police, and he's written a book called Surviving a Mass Killer Rampage. Oy, oy, oy.
Yeah. Gosh.
Police are minutes away. When seconds count, and police are minutes away. Oy, oy, oy.
I know.
Dr. Mashi Seibel, is that how you say it?
Yes, that's his name.
Serves on the Harvard Medical School faculty. He's the editor of My Menopause magazine.
That's right, he's a guy.
He's contributed to the Huffington Post, MSNBC, Today. This is a guy, huh, Mackie?
Yeah.
The effects of menopause and early menopause, curled perimenopause, on women and their families. Fun with Joe today. It's election day.
Yes, it is.
So all in favor, say aye.
Talk like a pirate.
All in favor, say aye. No, that's what you're supposed to say, right? Have you ever been any place where you were voting for something? And they say, all in favor, say aye.
Oh, yes.
All in favor, say nay.
Right.
Nay.
Exactly.
Aye, nay.
Yeah.
Anyway, so it's all about aye today.
I go,
nay. Oh. Okay. When Galen Unold is on the phone today, Donald Trump says that Bill Belichick has endorsed him as the presidential candidate. I'm not questioning that. I just thought, well, I wonder what other celebrities are endorsing the candidate. So I have a whole list. Who's endorsing whom? Plus, I have this interesting thing here about the World Series and presidential candidates. I thought I would share that with Galen as well.
Okay, excellent.
So we don't know who's going to be the next president yet.
No.
But we know that the Cubs won.
Yes.
So you see, in history, in the future, it'll look back at 2016 as saying the Cubs won and fill in the blank became president.
Biff. like you pointed out the other day.
Biff, yes.
Yeah.
Biff became president.
Not Biffette, Biff.
Yeah, people are so passionate about this presidential election. It's just amazing to me. Mm-hmm. So we'll talk about that. You know, I have a quick little story to tell you. So our friend Doug is fighting a urinary tract infection.
Uh-huh.
So he was in the hospital for a couple of days. He's doing fine. I visited him. He's not in the hospital anymore. He's like in an assisted living facility.
Yep.
Rehabilitating, whatever.
Yes.
So I pushed him out to the gazebo in a wheelchair, and we had a soda and some pretzels and stuff.
I guess he's doing okay if he can have soda and pretzels.
He's doing fine. So I've been taking care of his cat, as you know. His cat's name is Precious. So I've been taking care of Precious. So I know it's just a block away, but typically what I do, because the cat likes to go inside and eat, and the cat is really an outdoor cat, so I don't want to leave the cat in there, but at the same time, I don't want to wait for the cat to finish eating.
No.
Because cats are not like dogs. They will take their time.
Exactly.
So what I do is I don't need to drive to Doug's place because it's just a short walk, but I drive not to his place, but on my way to someplace else. Mm-hmm. So I'll pull in the driveway, get out of the car. The cat sees me there, knows that I'm there to feed her. I go in the door. The cat makes a beeline right to the cat bowl.
Mm-hmm.
And, of course, I put food in it if there is none. And then the cat eats. I leave, close the door. And then when I come back, you know, I get out of the car, of course, and go inside. The cat's ready to come out because the cat's an outdoor cat. Cat sees me get into my car and drive away.
Mm-hmm.
So yesterday I went home and I forgot to feed the cat. So I'm thinking, oh my gosh, I forgot to feed the cat. So instead of driving down there, I walked down there.
Uh-huh.
Now I waited for the cat to eat. I sat in the chair, I played with whatever on my phone, or just looked on a little dog. Listen to the cat crunching. All right, so the cat's done eating. I said, okay, you're done. You're feeling better. Good. Okay, I'm gonna go now. You gotta go outside.
Yeah.
Right. So I put the cat outside and I close the door. Now I'm walking home, and I have a shadow. And I'm saying, no.
She loves you.
You don't want to follow me, but there's no way around it. Well, then there's a cat outside my house. I don't know what cat it is. So I guess those two cats are friends. So I said, oh, okay, just visiting your friend. So I go inside, and that's the end of that. This morning I get up, Robin.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know the cat liked breakfast. This morning I got up, and I'm ready to come here. It's dark out, you know, come here. So I open up the door into my right through my door. Here comes the cat. Meow, meow, meow. Looking for food. I said, I don't have any food. I don't have anything. I'm looking to see what I have. I have some frozen hot dogs. I said, that's not going to work. I said, well, maybe you just want water. I put water down. Nah, that's not what you want. She's like, nothing here. Then I remembered that you brought over a can of tuna. So I said, I wonder if the tuna will work. So I open up the can of tuna, and if you're wondering where the can of tuna went, that's where it went. So I put it down, and the cat is just having a great breakfast. So
now
I'm sitting there waiting for the cat to be done so I can go to work. And finally the cat is finished. Of course, the cat doesn't eat. The cat can't even eat a whole can of tuna. You would think a whole can of tuna would be nothing for a cat.
I know, it's not that big.
But no, she was fine. Mm-hmm. Cats are not dogs.
No.
It's like women and men. A man could eat that whole can of tuna. A dog could too. One bite.
That's right.
One bite would be gone.
So did she leave then?
No, she came over to me looking for some loving, some hugging, some petting.
Yeah, so animals like to be loved.
So I said, I got to go to work. You can't be in here. So I put her out. And then, of course, she's like, I said, well, no, there's nothing else. There is nothing else. There's food, a little hug, and you're done.
That's right.
And then, of course, I get into that mystery thing called the car, which she doesn't quite get.
Yeah.
Where does he go when he gets in that machine? So I think I have a cat right now. I just hope when Doug gets better that the cat says, there's my real guy.
Right.
This other substitute, he was no good.
Well, you're going to have to take your car every day then. You can't just walk up there like you did.
Yeah, but now she knows. All right, there's something happening at 10 o'clock this morning I want you to know about, because if you could get over there, it would mean so much to these folks. They've been working so hard to put together the Marion County Veterans Resource Center. And they are having an event this morning. We were calling it a soft opening. I don't think that's what it is, although I'm not sure. Mm-hmm. I think it's basically what are they calling it?
Because it's still construction. It's still got a fence around it.
And I know, but they're calling vehicles. It something.
Oh
my gosh, not a christening. What do you call it? We should make this note shorter.
Yeah,
anyway, they're having an event this morning at 10 o'clock. Congressman Ted Yoho will be there. County Commission Chairwoman Kathy Bryant will be there. County Commissioner Stan McLean will be there. Marion County Tax Collector George Albright will be there. Hank Whittier will be there from Vets Helping Vets. Jeffrey Askew from Marion County Veterans. I think Joe Martone will be there from WOCA and Vets Helping Vets. Anyway, so there's an event happening this morning at 10 o'clock. I think it's a commitment ceremony or...
Oh.
I'll look for the word. We'll be right back.
Fox News Radio, I'm Rich Dennison. Both Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton have wrapped up their final full day of campaigning with stops in battleground states. Trump hitting Grand Rapids, Michigan early this morning.
We're going to win today, and we're going to Washington, D.C. to drain the swamp.
Hillary Clinton ending the night in Raleigh, North Carolina.
There is no reason, my friends, why America's best days are not ahead of us.
A record number of Americans have voted ahead of Election Day, driven by soaring turnout from Latino voters. According to Associated Press data, more than 43 million people have cast ballots by early voting. Record levels have been reported in 23 states and the District of Columbia. The Associated Press estimating that early voting could top 50 million. Fox News, we report, you decide.
Blue is my favorite color. What's yours?
What's yours?
Red is my favorite color. What's yours?
What's yours?
Well, yeller's sweller for this little feller.
And me, I'm keen on green.
So what's your favorite color? Please?
Kids will spend 20 minutes listening to songs like
what's
this.
What's your favorite color? Tell us, please. What's your favorite color? What's your favorite color? What's your favorite color? What's your favorite?
How about 2 minutes to brush their teeth? Brushing for 2 minutes now can save your child from severe tooth pain later. For fun 2-minute videos to watch while brushing, visit 2min2x.org. 2 minutes twice a day. They have the time. A message from the Partnership for Healthy Mouths, Healthy Lives and the Ad Council.
Hey everybody, did you know that there is a black bear sanctuary right here in the Ocala National Forest? While FWC has postponed the bear hunt this year, there are still perils that these magnificent creatures face. Forest Animal Rescue is finishing their state-of-the-art sanctuary on 80 acres in the Ocala National Forest. The last phase of construction is the on-site clinic to help with bear cub rehabilitation and release. Forest Animal Rescue is a 501c3. Your contribution is entirely tax-deductible. Visit forestanimalrescue.org.
Next Generation MD is the future of healthcare now. Listen in the first and third Thursday at 10 a.m. to learn how the future in PRP treatments are here in our area. Find out the many ways that Dr. Juan Jordan, MD, Charles Brooks, NP, and case manager Mark Shaw have brought the family medicine practice to a new level. Hear from the very people that benefit from the fine work they have done in this field. Next Generation MD, every first and third Thursday at 10 a.m. here on WOCA 96.3 FM, 1370 AM, The Source.
Experience Christmas at Gaylord Palms, presented by Fujifilm Instax, November 18th through January 1st. Enjoy spectacular holiday decor, dining, and entertainment, including ice, with an all-new theme featuring a Charlie Brown Christmas, Cirque Dreams Unwrapped stage show, breakfast with Charlie Brown and friends, Alpine Rush snow tubing, and much more. It's everything Christmas in one extraordinary place. Tickets and overnight packages, including priority extra cool hour admission to ice, are on sale now at christmasatgaylordpalms.com.
Christmas time is here, and this holiday season, Gaylord Palms puts a brand new twist on a Christmas classic. It's Ice, presented by Pepsi, featuring A Charlie Brown Christmas by Charles Schulz, November 18th through January 1st. See the whole Peanuts gang carved in over 2 million pounds of colorful ice, including Snoopy's decorated doghouse, and dancing at the holiday play rehearsal. Your awe-inspiring experience concludes with the wonder of the nativity in ice. For tickets and packages, visit christmas@gaylordpalms.com.
We all know the story of David and Goliath. It proves the underdog can win against all the odds. I'm Walt Dartland, and I'm running to become your congressman for District 2. And I'm in an epic battle for votes, but I'm not afraid to fight for your vote. I'm a veteran who proudly served the United States Marine Corps, and as a Marine, I will not let you down. But I need you to help me so I can fight for you in Washington. On November 8th, cast your vote for me, Walt Dartland, for Congress.
Paid for and approved by Walt Dartland, Democrat for Congress.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that,
I need too. My seat replaced.
Yep, we do that, too.
I need a new roofline and a new spoiler and a new
truck. Yep, we can even do that, too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show, too.
Well, as a matter of fact, join me, Matt Gibbs, from Sunrise Automotive, every Tuesday at 10 for auto repair with personal care right here on The Source.
25 minutes before 8 o'clock. Thank you for tuning in this Tuesday morning. It's an exciting day. It's election day. It's the day so many of us have been waiting for one reason or another. Many of us just to see it over and done with. A lot of people say whoever is the president, things won't change a whole lot. Some people say things will change a whole lot. Some people are afraid it'll be for the worse. Some people are happy for the better. La, 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 la. It goes on and on and on. Today is more than the presidential election. I know I don't need to tell you that. So I want to go over some of these things. Some of them have nothing to do with the elections at all. But this is the best time at all during the course of the morning, typically, where you'll be able to call in and express your thoughts. So if you want to do that, the number is 622-9622. Okay, before the break, I was mentioning the new Veterans Resource Center. Mm-hmm. Here in Marion County, and this is a project that Hank Whittier and the Vets Helping Vets guys and gals have been working on for a very, very long time, and it's a dream come true for them and for local vets. It's a blessing because the way I understand it is prior to this, and it's not open yet, but when it's open, it'll solve a problem, which is simply that when a veteran needs help in one area or another, he or she is then goes from one office, has to get into a car, to another office for different paperwork, whatever it is they have to run all over town for. If it's all in one building, it'll make it a lot easier. Mm-hmm. And so that's what's happening. So it used to be a bowling alley. I can't remember what it was, AMF or one of those.
Yeah.
Over near the Marion County Library Headquarters building, the big library on Silver Springs Boulevard.
Same parking lot.
Oh, is that right? They use the same parking lot?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's all right there. Same.
And if you know where the Marion County Veterans Memorial Park is,
yep.
Ocala, American, right? That's what we call it?
Yep.
Then you know where all of this stuff is. So anyway, at 10 o'clock this morning, and I was stumbling over the word soft opening because I don't know if it is a soft opening or not.
Mm-hmm.
I've heard it referred to as a soft opening.
Right, Hank referred to it as that.
So it might be. And in my mind, what is a soft opening? In my mind, a soft opening is you can go in and check it out, but everything's not done.
Right.
And I don't want to say that for sure because I don't know if that's what they're doing.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you're going to be able to take a tour of the building or not. So that's why I'm not sure. But it is a dedication ceremony. So,
okay.
So we'll just leave it at that. If they open the door and let you walk around inside, I don't know what you're going to see other than, you know, construction. But
mm-hmm.
Anyway, so the building dedication ceremony is at 10 a.m. this morning if you want to go. Again, the list of dignitaries includes Joe Martone from
yep.
here at WOCA.
And he's on the board.
Also on the board of the Marion County Vets Helping Vets.
Mm-hmm.
Jeffrey Askew, who is the director for the Marion County Veteran Services. Hank Whittier. The executive director of Vets Helping Vets, also the host of the Veterans News Program here in WOCA. George Albright, Marion County Tax Collector. Stan McLean, Marion County Board of County Commissioners. Kathy Bryant, the chairwoman for the Marion County Board of County Commissioners. And Congressman Ted Yoho, all will be there. I'm sure there will be others there also who I'm not mentioning, but those are the names on the list that I was given. So the only thing I want to tell you else is the address. Because if the landmarks didn't help, then you'll need your little GPS or your map, however you do this.
Mm-hmm.
The address is... Drum roll, please. Robin, they need a public service person.
I know, writer. They need somebody to tell them how to write.
2730 East Silver Springs Boulevard. That's the address. 2730 East Silver Springs Boulevard, okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right. All right. Just wanted to mention all that. And everybody's invited to go there. All right. Today is Election Day. Let's see. You want to hear some numbers real quickly?
Yep.
David Elsperman and Cynthia Moody are facing off each other for the office of clerk of the court. He has $46,000+ in monetary contributions and $3,000+ in in-kind contributions. She has $12,000 or almost $13,000 in monetary contributions. Not anywhere near as much as he does.
No.
The two candidates for sheriff, Billy Woods and Dennis McFadden. Billy Woods has $137,000, and just about $7,000 in kind, and that's a lot more than Mr. McFadden, who has $78,000 in contributions and $3,400 in kind contributions.
Mm-hmm.
Money is a weird thing when it comes to elections.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Who else? Let's see. Some of these are already done. Some of these finished up with the primaries. Well, anyway. So, it's county commissioners. Oh yeah, county commission. David Moore has $92,000 in contributions and $13,000 in in-kind contributions. John Townsend has only $28,000 and $5,000 in in-kind. Well, $28,900
mm-hmm.
for John. So he's got a lot less than David. Where are these guys spending this money? I thought there was. I don't hear any ads on the radio.
No.
For anybody.
Nope.
Just a few people.
Yeah, they're not buying any time. They're sending out pretty flyers that go on the truck.
There you go. So those are the things. All right, let's take some phone calls, and that's what this is about. Good morning. You're on the air.
Hey, good morning, Larry and Robin. It's Mark calling.
Hey, Mark calling. How you doing?
I'm doing great, and I just want to comment. I was listening to the show yesterday, but Robin had made a comment about her trip down to Tampa, and I'm glad she's back safely. But all the Trump-Pence flags that she saw, which I'm sure were quite plentiful, and they were hanging on cranes, I don't deny that. But what I can specifically say, those were not union cranes, those are not union American workers. Now, the crane operators traditionally on jobs all over the United States, because of the seriousness of them and the demand for English language, are traditionally Caucasian or black Americans, and not too many Spanish people are working in cranes yet because of their severity, and you can hurt somebody when a crane collapses or tips over or let's go on the line. But I would say, conversely, though, that the majority of construction work being done on highways and in many capacities being done by Latin people. So though they may be flying Trump-Pence flags, the Latin voters down on the ground with the shovels and hammers. But I just want to clear Robin up on that. I know her husband's, what, a union pipe fitter, Robin?
Yeah. But I didn't mention ethnicity yesterday. I didn't use the word Latin or black or white or anything.
I am being specific. They're not union workers, though. And union workers, we say the Pledge of Allegiance practically every day, and we all speak English. We're all trained by OSHA. But that's the difference between union and non-union. And the unions, for the listeners that don't know, we give 100% of our money to the party, and we will support Hillary, and we love her. So have a great day, you guys.
There you go. Thank you. That's what it's all about.
Not all union workers vote straight ticket.
I doubt that anybody. I doubt that any blanket statement is going to be true.
Yeah,
this
exactly.
That's my feeling on this. There is no blanket statement that is true. You mm-hmm. can't say all fill in the blank are voting fill in the blank.
Right.
You just can't do it. It's just not going to be true.
No.
This election, probably any election, by the way. So. They are expecting, who knows who they are, they are expecting voting numbers to be record-breaking today.
Yeah, I'm glad.
What I actually find a shame is that because of the passion behind the presidential elections this time around, that more people are predicted to show up to vote.
Right.
What? Why it's a shame is because you should, A, everybody who's showing up to vote today should show up every time there's an election, not just on presidential elections. There was not a huge number at the primaries, you know. And also the Marion County Sheriff and the County Commissioners, those are pretty important positions.
They are.
You know, they will affect you right here. I'm not saying the president won't affect you. He will or she will. Mm-hmm. But the, it's a little disappointing when you realize that a lot of people are going to the polls to vote for the president. Mm-hmm. And then they're going to see on their sheet or wherever they, whatever they're using. I think everybody doesn't use the same form we use, but they're going to see other names, and either they're going to ignore them all and just do the president and get out of there, or they're just going to pick and choose based on names and not have done any study.
Right.
This is my belief. Now, I know I'm not talking to any of them because talk show listeners think these things through. We disagree, but we think these things through. All right, we'll take a little break. I see the thing. We'll be right back. This is The Source.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Safe boating is no accident. On this Tuesday, Election Day, partly sunny skies with a high of 78 to 82. Tuesday night will be partly cloudy with lows ranging from 59 inland to 63 along the coast. For Wednesday, partial sunshine, high 76 to 80. Heading into Thursday, intervals of clouds and sunshine, high 75 to 79. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
Career Source Citrus Levy Marion brings together business and community partners, economic development leaders, and educational providers to connect employers with qualified, skilled talent and job seekers with employment and career development opportunities. Tune in the first and third Wednesday of each month at 9:30 a.m. to Career Source Citrus Levy Marion and learn how they can help you.
Hi, my name is Erica Olstein. I'm a doctor of acupuncture and oriental medicine. So, you used to be wired, now you're just tired. You used to be thin, but now you're the heaviest you've ever been. You don't necessarily always have to take a med if your thyroid is playing dead. If you have a thyroid disorder, an acupuncture visit may be in order. Come visit me, your primary care physician, Erica Olstein, at A Better You Healthcare. Call me at 352-615-5566.
That was the sound of a tree falling. It could be your tree. You're going to have it trimmed. Never got around to calling Pride Tree Service. It could have fallen in a field. And now all you have to do is call Pride Tree Service and they'll have it quickly out of the way for a great price. But don't wait until the tree falls. It may not fall in the field. It may hit your car, your house, or worse. So call Pride Tree Service today and avoid all those headaches before they happen. Pride Tree Service, 572-2510. That's 572-2510.
Veterans Day in the U.S. is also known as Armistice Day in other parts of the world, and it honors the many military who have fought for freedom. It is also the anniversary of the signing of the armistice that ended World War I. Major hostilities formally ended at the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month in 1918. The folks at the Voice of South Marion join you in remembering military past and present.
Hi, I'm Leah Caruso with Strive Rehabilitation, inviting you to join me Thursday at 11 a.m. for Health Matters. Ocala Health and Strive have teamed up to bring you the latest information on good health services available to you right here at home. This vital information will help you make informed decisions about your health. So don't forget to join me here at 11 a.m. Thursday. It's news you can use from Ocala Health, Strive, and your friends here at WOCA.
All right, 12 minutes before 8 o'clock. Thank you for tuning in. Kind of an exciting day, huh? So, when did the polls open here, Robin? 7? Did they open?
7 a.m.
So, they're open already. Okay. Yep. I hope if you go and you have a long line that you aren't discouraged. That's what I hope. I'm so glad we have early voting. I was able to get in. I went to the Dunellen Public Library to vote, and there was no line at all when mm-hmm. I went. So that was a week or so ago.
That's right.
The let's see, Mark brought up the unions, and I have let's see, Hillary does have a lot of unions for her. United Steelworkers and International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers support Hillary.
Mm-hmm.
The Fraternal Order of Police, which calls itself the largest police union in the world, endorses Trump.
Okay.
Interesting. Huh?
Very interesting.
So I don't know. All right, let's see. What else do we have here? Donald Trump is off to a very early lead in the 2016 presidential election, winning over the voters of three New Hampshire precincts. How do they have this already?
I know.
32-25 over Hillary Clinton. Polls in the tiny New Hampshire towns of Dixville, Hart's Location, and Millsfield mm-hmm. opened just after midnight this morning and closed as soon as everyone had voted. Really?
Oh, my gosh.
Clinton won more votes in Dixville and Hart, but Trump was the overwhelming favorite in Millsfield with 16-4. Libertarian mm-hmm. Gary Johnson picked up 3 votes. Bernie Sanders, John Kasich, and 2012 Republican presidential nominee Mitt Romney got write-in votes. Under New Hampshire state law, communities with fewer than 100 voters can get permission to open their polls at midnight and close them as soon as all registered voters have cast their ballots. Wow, I didn't know that.
Wow, I didn't know that either.
What does it tell you, though? I mean, it's just a small little town.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, if everybody's voted already.
That is interesting,
isn't
it?
Gosh, you're not kidding.
Everybody who is voting is not necessarily at the mercy of gravity.
Mm-hmm.
Did you hear this?
No, I did not. I don't understand what you're saying.
I said
at the mercy of gravity.
Everybody who's voting in this election is not at the mercy of gravity.
I know. I don't understand that.
Let me explain.
Everybody.
Let me explain, Lucy.
Do the astronauts vote? I mean, the
guys
in the space
ding,
station?
Ding, ding, ding.
Okay,
NASA
now I got
said
it.
That astronaut Shane Kimbrough filed his ballot in the election from the space station. I guess he's the only American up there right now.
Oh, okay.
Good morning. You're on the air.
Good morning. I already read on, I want to say on USA Today that Hillary was off to an early lead because they only reported one of the precincts from New Hampshire. But isn't it interesting that when you report it, you mention all three of those precincts and Trump is ahead?
Yeah,
even though there's only, 25 people voting.
Wasn't the story itself confusing? It says, yeah, he's ahead in one of the town or two of the towns, which I don't know. No, she's ahead in two
right.
of them. She's ahead in two of them, Dixville and Hart. And he's ahead in one. I don't understand. I don't know. Yeah, you're right. And,
maybe he's ahead in popular vote.
And what does that show you? That shows you, how the press can spin anything.
Absolutely right.
Yeah.
Absolutely right. You didn't know any better to spin it. You just told the facts. Oh, what a good concept. But actually, those New Hampshire precincts have been reported early for years. It's a thing. It's a tradition.
Okay.
Those polls always open at midnight, and the whole town gathers, and those, 37 votes are cast. It's a big deal. And then that's it.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay. Isn't that something?
And it tells you really nothing.
Yeah, tells you nothing. That's
anyway,
absolutely true, yeah.
You guys have a wonderful election day.
Thank you.
Thank you. You too.
Yep.
So when I was in school, I had this teacher who taught us about propaganda.
Mm-hmm.
And here's how he taught us to understand what propaganda is. He says, the United States and Russia were in a race, and the runner for the United States came in first place, and the runner for Russia came in second place.
Mm-hmm.
And the United States had the headline, American wins race with Russia.
Mm-hmm.
And Russia had a headline, Russian comes in second place, American comes in second to last.
Oh, wow. There you go.
And that's how my teacher explained to us how to understand propaganda. Mm-hmm. If you read between the lines and figure out how things are worded, sometimes you'll see that you're being manipulated by somebody's clever writing. And of course,
yes.
I don't know better, so I can't do that kind of thing.
Uh-huh.
Good morning. You're on the air.
Yeah, good morning, guys.
Hi, Hugh. How are you?
Oh, very good. Thank you. I just like to remind everybody that the election day is an official display your flag day. So I want to see all those flags up today, for it's a great time in this country, and it's a wonderful privilege that we have, and we should have that flag flying all over the place.
That's right. Gotcha. Exactly. Gotcha. Thank you so much. Yeah. I did not know that it was an official day for the flag.
Raise your flag.
Now I know.
Makes sense.
Yeah.
Thank you, Hugh. You're a good flag guy. He's our go-to flag guy.
Yeah, he is. Hugh's great. Yeah. I love that. I love, it's patriotism all the way.
Smith & Wesson, an American gun manufacturer with roots going back to 1852, is trying to change its name.
Oh, my.
To American Outdoor Brands Corporation.
Oh.
According to the Wall Street Journal, the company will ask its shareholders next month to approve the name change. If it is approved, the company's handguns will still carry the name Smith & Wesson, currently known as Smith & Wesson, Wesson Holding Company. The company was acquired by Safety Hammer Corporation in 2002.
Nope, sales will go down.
No, I don't think so. Why would it go down? Because of the name?
Yeah, Smith & Wesson. I mean, gosh, that's an iconic name. I mean, everybody knows when they go buy a gun, if they like Smith & Wesson, that's what they ask for when they go in the store. We'll see what they vote.
Phone lines are open if you want to call in, by the way. You don't have to talk about whatever we're talking about. You're invited to call in and say whatever you want to say. Maybe you got something about the campaign. I absolutely understand if you want to do that. A firefighter in New York was in the marathon on Sunday, and the reason he's singled out in this story is because his run was to bring awareness to stillborn babies.
Oh.
Lieutenant Mark Donahue and his wife lost a daughter earlier this year in a stillbirth, and he wrote on Facebook, "This is from my Janie." 26 mile race. How do they run 26 miles?
Yeah, that was the New York Marathon.
Yeah. Do you know that? That's about the width of Long Island. I think it's 28 miles. Can you imagine just running from the South Shore to the North Shore of Long Island?
Wow.
I just can't imagine doing that. Good morning. You're on the air.
Larry, is that the width or the length of that island?
The width.
Oh, okay. I didn't realize it was that large. That's a pretty good size island. I just wanted to call back, Larry. It's for the listener's sake, it's Mark the Union guy. If I inferred that all Latinos are voting for Hillary, that's not what I was saying. And I also didn't want to infer to anyone that that all union people vote Democrat. I didn't say that either. So I just wanted to be honest about that, so it didn't sound like spin was being put on spin. But I would say, though, the political action committees that represent all 15 or 16 million of us across the country, not just the union carpenters, primarily give most of their money to the Democrats, but no surprise. And that in many cases, the Fraternal Order of Police and the Police Benevolence Associations across the country do not all belong to the AFL-CIO. Some of them are freestanding unions. So that's why there's some division there. And actually, in New York, the police in New York City are represented by the longshoremen. And they're also represented by the other big union, I think it's PBA or whatever it is, FOP. And the AFL-CIO was voting to kick them out, by the way, over shooting unarmed people. So that's another reason we support Hillary, and we do give 100% of our money to Hillary. So have a great day.
There you go. Good luck with it. Thank you, Mark. Appreciate that. Everybody's passionate about this election. There's no question about it. All right. Absolutely, in the non-political news, there's a strange noise reportedly coming from the bottom of the sea in one of Canada's northern territories. Wow. They're describing it as a hum. The sound has been heard throughout Fury and Hecla Strait, the channel of water in the Nunavut region. Nunavut, is that how you say it? A remote area in the northernmost territory of Canada. Some residents rely on hunting for their food there. According to a Canadian news outlet, a decline in sea mammals in the area noted over the summer has been attributed to the strange noise, which is supposedly audible through the hulls of boats. Wow.
Gosh,
that is crazy.
Isn't that something? This is about the election this morning, about a voting precinct.
First Baptist Church voting precinct electronic ballot reader was not working as of 7:05 a.m. Who is this from?
It's from Joe Martone.
Okay.
And,
okay.
Yeah, so he just wanted
to... So what does that mean? Don't go there to vote?
He just wanted you to announce that, and the people that are there to vote, they're all waiting with the ballots in their hand until the electronic one is, you know, until it's fixed. So you can go to vote, but then you got to stand there and have your ballot in your hand. Okay. Yeah.
Former New York City Mayor Rudy Giuliani thinks Republican Donald Trump will win the presidential election today. Didn't he resign from his mayorship because of illness? Well, now he's hoping to get a job if Trump wins.
You know, I think he didn't run for the next term because
he was sick,
illness, right?
Right,
yeah. Because of his illness, because everybody wanted him to run for president and he declined.
Well, he's hoping to get a job if Trump wins.
Yeah, well,
according to this.
Yeah.
All right, we will take a break. This is probably going to continue when we have Galen on. I just have a hunch, but we'll see. We're playing it by ear this week. We'll be right back.
Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
Fox News Radio, I'm Pat O'Neill. Election day has finally arrived. Hillary Clinton making her final pitch as the Democratic presidential nominee in Philadelphia last night.
Let's show tomorrow there will be no question about the outcome of this election.
Republican Donald Trump in Manchester, New Hampshire.
We are fighting for every citizen who believes that government should serve the people, not the donors and not the special interests. And we are fighting to bring us all together as America.
Tonight, Clinton will watch the returns with friends.
She and her aides will hunker down in Manhattan, preparing for their election night gathering at the Javits Convention Center. Donald Trump will also be watching returns in New York City from his home in Trump Tower. Then it's just a short ride over to the New York Hilton for his election night party.
Fox's Gary Baumgarten. Fox News, we report, you decide.
It's Thursday night, and you're grabbing drinks with some friends. Started off with a pitcher for the table, which quickly becomes two. There's pool. Oh! And there's the photo booth.
All right, everybody squeeze in. Say cheese!
Followed naturally by an order of wings. And another.
Can we get some extra ranch sauce?
Then there's the ceremonial nightcap.
So what are we doing this weekend?
And lastly, it's back to the car, which, if you're buzzed...
6-8-9-10-4.
Order in the car.
Could be the most expensive night of your life. Getting pulled over for buzz driving could cost you around $10,000 in fines, legal fees, and increased insurance rates. Nothing kills a buzz like getting pulled over for buzz driving, because buzz driving is drunk driving. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
Hi, this is JP from Penn Flooring here in Ocala. I would like to invite you to come in and visit our spacious showroom where we have solutions for every style and budget. From wall-to-wall carpet to hardwood floors and tiles, we have an unsurpassed selection of flooring. At Penn Flooring, we've provided quality customer service with a family touch for over 25 years. Visit our website at pennflooring.com or come by our showroom, 1201 Southwest 17th Street, just over the bridge. Penn Flooring, quality customer service with a family touch.
It's the end of the fiscal year, and that means budget cuts and number crunching. Now's the time of the year you're evaluating your expenses, planning your budget, and finding ways to save money and increase efficiency to maximize profits. Dex Imaging understands and delivers. Call Dex Imaging today for a free document management evaluation. Cutting your office expenses is as easy as calling Dex Imaging, 352-266-0333. Start saving money today and increase your bottom line with Dex Imaging. Printers, copiers, and fax machines that increase office productivity and save you money. No one understands your bottom line better. Imaging today, 352-266-0333, or check them out on the web at deximaging.com. That's DEXImaging.com, or call 352-266-0333 for your free document management evaluation today.
I'm Walt Dartland, and I'm running for Congress in District 2 because you deserve a choice to get money out of politics, to receive a better, affordable health care, to make sure your tax dollars are respected, to keep promises to veterans, to protect Florida's environment. I'm a Marine veteran, a former Deputy Attorney General, and consumer advocate. I'm Walt Dartland, asking for your vote on November 8th.
Paid for and approved by Walt Dartland, Democrat for Congress.
Hi, I'm Seth with AA Lock, Dock, and Security. Have you ever thought about the locks or security on your house or business? Have you ever wondered why the keys to your new car cost so much? Well, at AA Lock, Dock, and Security, we can help with securing your valuables. We can even replace those expensive transponder keys. We can give you the knowledge that no one else will. Call AA Lock, Dock, and Security at 867-1965. That's 867-1965.
Hospice of Marion County has an urgent need for volunteers to share a conversation with someone, run errands, hold someone's hand. All you need is a willingness to help others. Our volunteers believe the blessings they receive far exceed the services they offer. Will you consider serving, caring, and making a difference? Call today, 873-7441. Hospice of Marion County, making more moments of life possible.
Thank you. 5 minutes after 8 o'clock, and exciting day. Today's an exciting day. Just last week, we were more concerned about the baseball thing.
Oh, that's right. I forget.
World Series.
That's right.
Gosh, the picture on the streaming video is kind of weird. It's got a.
Is it?
Yeah, it's got a big, gigantic glow. Right over my head. Is am I going to heaven right now? What's going on here? Am I dying?
Your angels are visiting you.
Look at the picture.
Let me see.
Look at the picture. See, okay. Look right there. It's just
wow.
A big gigantic glow over my head.
Wow.
Oh my gosh.
There. The angels are gracing you.
Galen Unold is gracing us. He's on the phone from LifeSouth Community Blood Center. He told me something cool. He told me that there's a website that's giving real. Exit poll information. Good morning, Galen.
Hey, good morning, Larry Robin. How are y'all?
Good. So, I think I went to where you told me to go today.
Okay.
Not when we were talking about building number 7. You told me to go someplace else that day, but I'm teasing.
We just disagree.
I'm teasing.
Yeah.
I don't know what it says. 1108, it says 81 and 62. 81 for Clinton, 62 for Trump. I don't know what that means.
Well, so here's what they're doing. There's a couple of news outlets, websites that are releasing the exit poll data that all the major media news uses, Fox
right.
News, CNN, ABC, NBC, when they talk about the exit poll data.
Right.
There's basically one company that does it, and there's always been this agreement that they won't release it until in each state until that state's polls close. And so this year, these two websites, I think it's Slate.com and ViceNews.com, decided, you know what, we're going to release this information live. And I'm curious as to if it'll have any reaction or any impact on the election.
Okay.
And my question is one, should that be done? Is that I don't know, you know, what the ethical side of it is. I mean, it's public information. I mean, these people can stand there and ask anybody anything they
right,
want
right, right,
to
right,
the
right.
answer or not. Mm-hmm. The question is what's the ethical boundaries of that? And there's mixed data. There's data that says that it kind of helps the underdog because the people who are winning goes, oh, my guy's going to win. I don't need to vote.
But
and
how do you know? I mean, there's no way to really know if people are telling the truth to the person asking the question.
Exactly.
Anyway, if you want to look, I think I found it, Galen. It's votecaster.us, and the caster is C-A-S-T-R. So V O T E C A T I'm sorry, VOTECASTR.US. And this is what it says. This says, VoiceCaster real-time data is live at Slate beginning at 8 a.m. Watch the War Room live at Vice at from 9 a.m. Eastern Time.
Okay, there you go.
So, if you can't...
And,
Florida. Yeah, and I think it's going to be fascinating because, you know, I take the belief that people are fairly honest when you ask them a direct question one-on-one. And that's what my business, my organization, my life is based on. Is that people at their heart are pretty truthful. I don't think people who exit a poll after they take their, you know, this right that we have in this country very seriously, and I don't think they go to the exit poll guys and lie. I just don't. And I think it seems true when they're doing these polls that people can like. So I just don't think people to come out and say, oh, I'm going to mess you up today. I voted for Andrew Jackson.
Pretty well.
No, I don't think they're going to do that.
I think you're right. The majority of people won't, but there'll be a couple of knuckleheads that'll say.
So let's say it's 98% accurate.
No, I got it.
98 out of 100 are going to be.
Yeah,
why these exit polls are dead on. So.
Okay, I'm not disagreeing with you. I'm sure they're very accurate. I'm just saying 100% of the people won't answer honestly, but you're right. The majority, enough of them will to make it accurate. Yeah, I think you're right.
But the best thing about this is that the people are voting, the media isn't voting, and the people talk one way and the media talks the other way from what we understand. So
yeah, but
the people are casting their votes.
I see what Galen's saying, and I think you're right.
You know, you're in the media, right, Robin? You're in the media.
Yes, I am. but we're not. But Larry and I don't try to sway people one way or the other.
Yes, you do.
Sure. Everybody does. Yeah, you do. Everybody does.
I honestly don't.
I mean, we had a discussion about Building 7. We were trying to sway each other. There's nothing wrong with it. I think the issue that everybody has is when you're trying to say that I'm a down-the-middle journalist, I'm not giving my opinion, and then the evidence shows that, wow, you're really slanted one way or the other. I think that's the problem people have. I don't think people have a problem with opinion. It's when you mix that opinion with news, that's where the problem comes.
Well, and in the context of a radio talk show, that's what you're here for. I mean,
that's exactly right.
We try to make it perfectly clear. Even when we do news bites, it's perfectly clear that there probably are opinions embedded in each one of these journalists' writings, but they're not Robin's or mine.
Mm-mm.
Robin's and mine happen now, as yours do.
Yeah.
Our opinions happen.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right. Yeah, and I think that's the line we're trying to walk.
Good morning. You're on the air.
Good morning, guys. Mike McCoy.
Hey, Mike.
you know, no matter who wins or who loses today, I think we should all, of course, everybody should vote. But I don't think we, as this country, we appreciate enough what a privilege it is for us to be able to go out and choose our leader. And vote. It isn't just, you know, don't take it so lightly. Yeah, well, maybe I'll go vote, or I'll wait for somebody else to do it. That is pretty much a pretty big consensus within this country is we're waiting for somebody else to do it. But don't wait for anybody to do your job. Go out and do your job and vote and elect our leaders. And hopefully we elect the right ones. I'm not going to sit here and say which one's right or which one's wrong. I have my choice. And thank goodness that I have the ability to make that choice in this country. So, anyway, go out and do it, people.
Absolutely, yeah, absolutely.
You know,
don't disagree with that. I want to add one thing to what Mike said. The audience that we talk to on a daily basis is on that same page.
Absolutely.
That's what a talk show audience is. It's the same exact thing. If you could get on to a top 40 station where you've got a young voter who might be just eligible to vote for the first time, 18, 19 years old, and persuade them to take time out today and go vote, then, because I don't think this audience needs any prodding. They've got their mind made up, Republican, Democrat, or neither. They're doing it. They're going out there. This is not that audience. That audience is listening right now to Sirius or XM or one of the pop stations or something like that. And and I'm not saying all of them. No blanket statement is true. But there are a number of them. I don't think there are any talk show listeners who aren't going to vote unless they're criminals and they can't.
Yeah, right. Exactly.
But
I think that's just exactly right. You're exactly right, Larry.
But I think if somehow we could, and that's why is in spite of the fact that I'm always cringing when a celebrity talks politics, Justin Bieber or
Beyonce,
Lady Gaga or
First
any
of all,
them.
You know, Justin Bieber can't vote because he's Canadian.
All right, I picked the wrong name. Okay, no. But Lady Gaga was pitching for Hillary this morning.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay. I'm just joking.
Beyonce was right out there.
So, and I'm okay with them doing that. Everybody's got the right to do that. But the good part about that is, in spite of the fact that I cringe a little bit, and I can explain why I cringe a different time. It's a showbiz feeling I have. But anyway, I do think it does get the attention of young voters, which I think is a good thing.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I think. So, because I'm never going to reach them. There's no way. There's no way they're listening to me at all. So
no.
You know, who reaches young voters? Their parents. If their parents voted and their parents expressed how important it was, then their kids are going to vote.
Good point.
I mean, that's why I voted. I mean, if I don't vote in every election, my mom calls me on election day and says, "Hey, did you vote?" Or she'll call me the day before. We talked yesterday because, you know, her father never had the right to vote until he was the year before he died, when he was 70. So, you know, that's where it ingrained in me.
Why?
And I think that's where it starts. Because he was a Native American and they couldn't pass the literacy test.
Oh, my gosh. Isn't that a shame? Wow.
So, you know, I mean, and my mom had a master's degree from the University of North Carolina and couldn't pass the literacy test and wasn't able to vote until she was in her 25, 26.
Huh.
So the right to vote, it's a right that we, as Mike said, we work really hard, but I think that has to be passed down to the next generation.
That's a really good point.
I love it. I love it when I see kids that, you know, their parents bring their kids to the polls. I bring my kids whenever I can to vote. And I think you have to teach them. You know, we so often think that, oh, yeah, well, they get it. They understand it. No, you have to go and teach them and show them.
Yeah, I think that's right. So. And again, I think this listening audience gets that. I think also the part that's kind of a little bit concerning is the fact that this is going to be record numbers because of Hillary and Trump.
Yes.
And those same numbers won't show up next time there's a minor election.
Oh, of course.
Right.
You know, those same numbers.
Yeah.
And when they do show up today, a lot of the people will say, oh, I'm voting for Hillary, here's my dot, or I'm voting for Trump, here's my dot, and then they're out of there. They're not even going to look at the rest of it, or if they do, they're just going to say, oh, gosh, oh, I have to do all this, too?
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh, what is this, a test? Sheriff?
Well, you know, the issue is that, you know, it's low-information voters. I was at my son's football practice yesterday, and you know, the issue came up, and everybody had, and somebody stopped and said, well, who'd you vote for sheriff? And they're like, oh, I don't know either one of them. So, and I'm like, oh, and we had this discussion.
Yeah, that's crazy.
There's more information than ever.
I know.
There's something called Ballotpedia, and I don't know if you've ever looked at that, but it's amazing. So you can go on the Ballotpedia, and it will give you all the information.
Well, all you have to do is go to Vote.
Possibly use.
And if you go to VoteMarion.com, if you live here,
yeah,
there you go.
Click on any of those names, and you can go to their websites, and you can read whatever you want to read. Can I tell you a quick story?
I will tell you, Ballotpedia, you don't have to click anywhere. All that information is on the same page.
I want to tell you a quick story, all right?
Please do.
I sat on a bench in Washington Square Park in New York when I was up there with Alex a month ago. And next to me was a guy talking on the phone, and I think he wasn't really talking to anybody. I think he was just making believe. And then he hangs up, and then he says to me, have you ever done anything good for anybody? And I said, yes. Of course, now I'm expecting he's going to ask me for some money,
yeah,
which he probably was, because he said the park I was in is Lower Manhattan. He wanted to get to the Bronx, which he needed money for the subway. So anyway, but he never did ask for it, so I didn't give it to him.
Yeah.
But anyway, but he started talking about the presidential campaigns, Hillary versus Trump. He said, what has Donald Trump done for anybody? He says, the Clinton Foundation has done so much for so many people.
Yeah.
Why would anybody vote for Trump? So I said, well, then vote for Hillary. And he looked at me like, that's not what it takes. It doesn't take my vote. And I was like, yes, it does. I mean, your vote. In other words, he didn't like my answer that if that's who you're supporting, then go vote for her.
Yeah, exactly.
He didn't like that answer. He wanted it to be across the board. Let's just put her in there, you know, without voting.
Yeah.
And to me, what it sounded like was he didn't want to go vote. He didn't want to take the time to go vote.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought, well, that's exactly the wrong reason. Because if our founding fathers had one thing that I think was true, is that more heads are better than one. Two heads are better than one.
Mm-hmm.
So if we all disagree on something and then we go vote on it, the likelihood that the best answer is going to come from the majority is usually right.
Mm-hmm.
Not always, but I think
I think it depends on who the judge is. Because the American people are against the Affordable Health Care Act. They're against the gay marriage. They were against a lot of things that the court passes.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Yeah, you're absolutely correct.
Yeah, I know,
that's how our system is based.
But the premise, the premise behind the whole jury system,
mm-hmm.
Extends itself all the way to the electoral, to electorates, mm-hmm. and so I think their thinking was, well, let the majority of the people choose, and then of course let it be a republic so that it's not just a democracy. And it was smart. I mean, my gosh, what a brilliant design we have here in this country.
Mm-hmm.
But if people don't go vote, then the whole thing doesn't work. So.
No. And he like you said, he was probably looking for a handout, and that's what he's looking for the government. He's looking for a handout. He yeah. wants to not work or do anything, but just get that check.
You could be right, yeah.
So, and that's apathy. That's, I hate that.
I do have a couple things I wanted to tell Galen, but first let me ask him about the blood supply. How is the blood supply right now?
Again, we're okay. We have a just over a 7-day blood supply, and we just need platelets. So get out there and vote and donate blood. Do your civic duty today.
That's right. And you said yesterday, LifeSouth Community Blood Centers is a polling place up in Gainesville.
Yep, sure is.
Nice.
Palm Garden of Ocala.
It'll be very difficult to park today.
Palm Garden of Ocala and Penn Flooring are both sponsoring that message that Galen just delivered. So thank them for doing that. Go visit Palm Garden of Ocala. You will see for yourself when you first walk through the door. This is a clean facility. Number one concern probably of most people is how clean is it? Number two is how good is the health care? Well, it's a skilled nursing health mm-hmm. center, and not everyone can say that. Not every facility can say that. They have 21st century equipment for therapy. Go check it out. You'll see what I'm talking about.
They're wonderful.
The rooms are spacious. The hallways are wide. The people are the best. The culinary staff is top-notch, and of course the activities department and everybody in between. Go there and take a tour for yourself, and visit Palm Garden of Ocala at 2700 Southwest 34th Street. And as you're walking into your office this morning, look at the floor. Maybe you want a new carpet or a new wood floor. Go to Penn Flooring. They can help you out, maybe in your home. They are located at 1201 Southwest 17th Street, just over the McKay-Williams Bridge. Thank them for sponsoring the segment with LifeSouth with Galen Unold. Take a little break real quickly. We'll be back. We'll probably continue talking about the elections. And I'm going to see if I can get this information off of that website Galen was talking to us about. We'll be right back.
Howdy, folks. For over four decades, we at Dairy Queen have been proud to serve our customers with the finest and freshest cook-to-order, quick-service comfort foods in the world. For instance, our new Philly steak and cheese sandwiches with grilled peppers and onions on an artisan focaccia bread bun. So steaming hot and yummy, you won't believe it. We also added seasoned potato skins filled with queso cheese and bacon. Wow, they're tasty. So come on down to Dairy Queen at Silver Springs, where we always treat you like kings and queens.
Hi, this is JP from Penn Flooring here in Ocala. I would like to invite you to come in and visit our spacious showroom where we have solutions for every style and budget. From wall-to-wall carpet to hardwood floors and tiles, we have an unsurpassed selection of flooring. At Penn Flooring, we've provided quality customer service with a family touch for over 25 years. Visit our website at pennflooring.com or come by our showroom, 1201 Southwest 17th Street, just over the bridge. Penn Flooring, quality customer service with a family touch.
The very best in quality is Captain T's Upholstery.
Hey, this is Dan. Let me ask you a few questions. Does your boat look better with the cover on? Has your car's interior seen its better days? Stop using a towel to cover up those rips in the golf cart. Isn't it about time you had it restored to better than new with a custom upholstery from Captain T? Captain T's Upholstery has been right here in Ocala for nearly 20 years, so they know how to make your ride one of a kind. Whether you want to take that classic ride back to a factory look or put your favorite sports team front and center, Captain T's Upholstery is who to call. 352-369-1810. That's 352-369-1810. Or stop by their location, 5030 South Pine Avenue in Ocala, just past the drive-in. And of course, don't forget to visit them on the web, CaptainTUpholstery.com.
The very best in quality is Captain T's Upholstery.
Palm Garden wants to get to the heart of the matter. If you've been in the hospital as a cardiac patient, maybe you have a pacemaker or congestive heart failure or an arrhythmia, or perhaps you're a heart bypass patient, then consider Palm Garden as your rehab choice. With proven outcomes, second to none, Palm Garden fixes broken hearts. Call today at 854-6262. That's 854-6262.
We all know the story of David and Goliath. It proves the underdog can win against all the odds. I'm Walt Dartland, and I'm running to become your congressman for District 2. And I'm in an epic battle for votes, but I'm not afraid to fight for your vote. I'm a veteran who proudly served the United States Marine Corps, and as a Marine, I will not let you down. But I need you to help me so I can fight for you in Washington. On November 8th, cast your vote for me, Walt Dartland, for Congress.
Paid for and approved by Walt Dartland, Democrat for Congress.
24 minutes after 8 o'clock. Thank you for tuning in. Galen Unold on the phone from LifeSouth. Remember, when you go vote, also go and donate blood. It takes about a half hour to donate blood. Probably takes about a half hour to vote by the time everything is said and done. Although, if there's a long line today, it won't be the voting that takes that much time. It's going to be waiting to get to vote,
yeah.
Right?
Yep.
I don't know. It's going to be curious to see what the lines are like this morning or today. Galen, have you ever considered running for any office at all?
Yeah.
And what happened?
I almost ran for mayor, but I didn't live in Ocala. I was living in Gainesville at the time. I almost did. Almost ran for mayor.
Let's see. Donald Trump says he has the endorsement of Bill Belichick.
Mm-hmm.
Did you see that?
Yeah.
That was in the news?
I did.
And so that brought to mind, well, what other candidates are supporting who? And I'll give you a list of some of them. Are you ready?
Let's just assume that everybody who's in music, television, movies, is voting for Hillary. Let's just assume that.
Okay. That's interesting. Yeah, let's say if you're right. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, Hillary.
He's a Muslim. he's not going to vote for Trump.
Okay. I'm going to try and go back and forth between the Republican and the Democrat one.
I know. One list is a lot longer than the other.
Tim Allen. Tim Allen is voting for Trump.
Yeah, he's a Trump guy.
Good.
It goes with his image.
Ben Affleck. Hilton. I'm a Hilton.
Oh, he's a big Clinton.
Hillary.
Big Clinton.
Yeah, Ben Affleck.
Now, even though there's no proof that he's ever voted.
Stephen Baldwin voting for Trump.
That, there's a whole war between he and his brother Alec, because Alec is making fun of him on Saturday Night Live. So
Matt Damon, Clinton.
Oh, huge Clinton supporter. He's a climate change guy. As he flies around his jet, he tells everybody climate change.
Kirstie Alley, Trump.
Good for her.
That makes sense.
Good for her.
Hasn't done anything but lose weight, gain weight, almost commit suicide. I mean, don't know if that's what he wanted.
Listen to you.
He looks horrible now. I saw a picture of him. I'm like, oh.
I should have done this earlier. This is funny.
Well, she was in the Star Trek movie.
Danny DeVito.
She looked hot then.
Who do you think he's
playing? No, she was best known for Cheers. Let's be honest. She was best known for Cheers.
Danny DeVito.
Oh, Danny DeVito's Hillary.
He is Hillary, yes.
Yeah.
Kid Rock. Trump.
Well, Kid Rock is, for of guns. Course, he's from Trump.
Because he's for guns.
Yeah.
Hillary's not
you
for
gotta,
guns.
You got to remember who these people's audience is. And if Kid Rock were to get up at one of his concerts right. and say, hey, I'm voting for Hillary, he right. would literally be stoned on the spot.
Drew Barrymore voting for Clinton.
Oh, come on. Of course she is.
Johnny Damon.
She wants to play the character that needed that Clinton support.
Johnny Damon, Trump.
I don't
Which
know.
Johnny Davis?
Major League Baseball
player star. Johnny Davis?
Baseball player, yeah.
Oh, God. He was, yeah, that guy's a moron. He is as dumb as a box of rocks.
Okay.
By the way, he won a World Series for the Boston Red Sox. So I love him, but he's as dumb as a box of rocks.
George Clooney is voting for Clinton.
Of course.
Hillary.
Of course he is.
Of course.
Chuck Norris. He's voting for Trump.
Of course he's voting for Trump. He was a Huckabee guy. He was going to be Huckabee's vice president. That was the best thing that Mike Huckabee had was Chuck Norris.
I should have done this the whole segment.
Can you imagine a meeting between Chuck Norris and Vladimir Putin? That would be awesome. One is a karate guy and the other one's a jiu-jitsu.
Will Ferrell.
That would be amazing.
Will Ferrell, Clinton.
Of course, yeah. Hollywood.
Dennis Rodman, Trump.
Good for him.
Of course.
He's a good guy.
Dennis Rodman. I mean, Dennis Rodman's going to be his ambassador in North
funny.
Korea.
That's this a, is too
that's
funny. Elton
that's
John. It. Elton John. Clinton.
Right. A gay guy from England who can't even vote in the U.S. Who cares?
Yeah, there you go. Good
A rocket man.
Phil Robertson and Willie Robertson.
Trump.
Oh, there's Trump. A shock.
They're Duck Dynasty guys.
They're gun guys.
By the way, if you've ever, here's the rule. If you've ever worn camo in your life, you're voting for Trump.
That's right.
Oh my gosh. That's too funny. Morgan Freeman, Clinton.
Another, he doesn't believe in God, but he does all these things with God.
John Voight.
For Trump.
Trump.
Good for him. He's a good guy.
There you go. All right, we got 8 minutes. 8 minutes.
You can. It's so obvious. Where
15 seconds.
You know, it's hilarious because Robin loves everybody who's for Trump. Yeah, great guy.
Where is the Bloodmobile going to be? Where's the Bloodmobile going to be?
Taking away my gun.
At least taking away your gun. today we are at the Walmart in the Villages.
All right. Have a great day. Enjoy your day.
All right. Hey, my son's got his first soccer game tonight. It's going to be awesome. So.
Oh, congratulations!
Good luck.
Go Vanguard.
Yeah.
All right. Bye.
Should be fun tomorrow, too. We'll be right back.
Action.
Republican Bye. Donald Trump in Manchester, New Hampshire.
We are fighting for every citizen who believes that government should serve the people, not the donors and not the special interests. And we are fighting to bring us all together as America.
Tonight, Clinton will watch the returns with friends.
She and her aides will hunker down in Manhattan, preparing for their election night gathering at the Javits Convention Center. Donald Trump will also be watching returns in New York City from his home in Trump Tower. Then it's just a short ride over to the New York Hilton for his election night party.
Fox's Gary Baumgarten. Fox News. We report, you decide.
It's Thursday night, and you're grabbing drinks with some friends. Started off with a pitcher for the table, which quickly becomes two. There's pool.
Oh!
And there's the photo booth.
All right, everybody, squeeze in. Say cheese!
Followed naturally by an order of wings. And another.
Can we get some extra ranch sauce?
Then there's the ceremonial nightcap.
So what are we doing this weekend?
And lastly, it's back to the car, which, if you're buzzed...
680 to 90.
Order in the car.
Could be the most expensive night of your life. Getting pulled over for buzz driving could cost you around $10,000 in fines, legal fees, and increased insurance rates. Nothing kills a buzz like getting pulled over for buzz driving, because buzz driving is drunk driving. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
County, folks. For over four decades, we at Dairy Queen have been proud to serve our customers with the finest and freshest cook-to-order, quick-service comfort foods in the world. For instance, our new Philly steak and cheese sandwiches with grilled peppers and onions on an artisan focaccia bread bun. So steaming hot and yummy, you won't believe it. We also added seasoned potato skins filled with queso cheese and bacon. Wow, they're tasty. So come on down to Dairy Queen at Silver Springs, where we always treat you like kings and queens.
Hi, this is JP from Penn Flooring here in Ocala. I would like to invite you to come in and visit our spacious showroom where we have solutions for every style and budget. From wall-to-wall carpet to hardwood floors and tiles, we have an unsurpassed selection of flooring. At Penn Flooring, we've provided quality customer service with a family touch for over 25 years. Visit our website at pennflooring.com or come by our showroom, 1201 Southwest 17th Street, just over the bridge. Penn Flooring, quality customer service with a family touch.
The very best in quality is Captain T's Upholstery.
Hey, this is Dan. Let me ask you a few questions. Does your boat look better with the cover on? Has your car's interior seen its better days? Stop using a towel to cover up those rips in the golf cart. Isn't it about time you had it restored to better than new with a custom upholstery from Captain T? Captain T's Upholstery has been right here in Ocala for nearly 20 years, so they know how to make your ride one of a kind. Whether you want to take that classic ride back to a factory look or put your favorite sports team front and center, Captain T's Upholstery is who to call. 352-369-1810. That's 352-369-1810. Or stop by their location, 5030 South Pine Avenue in Ocala, just past the drive-in. And of course, don't forget to visit them on the web, CaptainTUpholstery.com.
The very best in quality is Captain T's Upholstery.
Did you know nearly 70% of the people in Ocala want cremation, yet it is amazing how many misconceptions there are? It is probably because we just do not want to talk about it. Often, people think cremation limits their options for burial. Some think that cremated remains cannot be buried. In reality, it is just the opposite. At Highland Memorial Park, they want to give you all the answers to any questions you have now so that you are prepared. Highland has become expert at creating beautiful and unique cremation gardens. They offer everything from simple in-ground urn burial to our air-conditioned celebration